Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. We thought maybe you'd like to take a quick little tour to see what's in bloom today. We just had to share our peony bush with you. This is one of several that we have. The aroma is wonderful. It is just in its glorious best. If it rained, they'd be ruined. They don't last long, but while they're here, they're spectacular. And they smell, to me, better than roses.
Well, that's a matter of opinion, but I don't know. I mean, they're pretty spectacular, and I would definitely say they're one of my favorites. Besides the iris, I love that Kool-Aid smell.
Yes.
But they're so delicate and lacy. I mean...
Well, look at that middle. Yeah. I mean, that's just
what a
fantastic
fireworks display.
And all the subtle colors, like this one. Look at this.
Pink, you go from pink to
and
white.
So as they open, they're pink, and as they mature, they get white. Have you seen the white ones over on the other side?
No, let's go take a look at those.
And then these are the dark singles. Somewhere we have doubles, but these are the singles. And then these are the double whites. When these open up, they are almost as big as a dinner plate. I mean, they get huge. Here's one down here, a little bit bigger. They get so big, they just fall over. Just look at that. That is gorgeous.
Yeah. Hundreds more are coming, maybe thousands. It's quite a bed of peonies you have here. It's a nice roadside bloom.
Yep.
As long as we're doing updates on flowers, let's go take a look at some of the other areas that are really, really spectacular in bloom right now.
One hint, if you like, if you want the largest possible flower, you would trim off all these secondary ones and just leave this one in the middle. And then you'll get an even bigger flower.
And if you let that go to seed?
Well, then you can start your own plan.
They do multiply quickly, though.
But they stay where they belong.
True.
Then we couldn't pass up this bush. I could look it up, what it is. It's not a bush, actually. It's a plant. It dies down to the ground each year. And I see we have a whole bunch of babies growing from last year. This was not bothered by last year's drought, by the way.
Well, this was another specimen plant that we got at Montez Farms.
Yes. Yes, and then the iris again. A light purple one. A pastel baby blue one. And an orange one.
Well, I think we have some black in here, red. Mm-hmm. I think we have about 7 or 8 different color varieties of irises.
Yep.
They're always pretty spectacular.
And then the poppies are starting. Blue flax. Planted these from seed last year. Then the California poppies, just starting.
Yep.
These are the rhododendron that I talk to all winter as I'm shoveling, and I'm shoveling snow on top of them and telling them spring will come and they'll be able to bloom, and they are.
Well, they're kind of sickly compared to the ones we've seen in California.
Oh my gosh, yes.
I mean, these are dwarfs in comparison.
And then columbine in front of bleeding heart, in front of lemon lilies, which are toward the end. Siberian or Japanese iris, I'm not quite sure which.
More poppy?
More California poppy.
They're so delicate. I mean, Mother Nature sure is creative.
And hardy. These were not bothered last year by the drought either. And these, I believe, will be a pinkish poppy once they open up. end of the alliums. I'm not sure what that is, but these will be, I want to say black-eyed Susans. I'm not sure, but we'll find out. And here's some more allium. Now, these were seeds last year that I sprinkled over here. So they have done amazingly well considering there was a drought.
And how about in the front?
Now, last week we did a video when this was only about 4 feet tall. I'm 5'9". That's how much it grew in 1 week. And you can see that it's starting to blossom out. And again, this has a unique smell. To me, it smells like leather or leather balm that you soften leather with. Saddle soap, that's what I'm trying to think of, saddle soap. And then these. To me, these are absolutely spectacular. They almost rival the peonies.
Yeah,
they are
something.
So amazing. If you're driving through the southeastern Wisconsin area this week, last week, and probably next week, you'll see off in the gullies these what appear to be lovely phlox plants. They are not. They're the bad ones. They're called Dame's Rocket. They are invasive. They'll take over. As pretty as they look, they are not the right ones. The good ones have five petals on them. These have four. The good ones, the regular normal phlox, are not invasive. They stay where you put them. These will take over a stream and choke out everything else. Bad, bad. These will be coming out.
Get rid of them.
This is just a shot of our front yard. You see the daisies are in profusion. If you don't want more daisies from the seeds, then you will chop them off before they go to seed. But it's a good idea to do that anyway, because you'll get a second blooming if you chop them down to maybe 6 inches. If you don't do that, they will spread their seeds everywhere. The good thing about these daisies is they're easy to pull up. So if you don't want them someplace, you just pull them up. No big deal.
So your peony trees...
Peony trees are done now.
Yeah.
I'm going to leave a few of the seed heads on. As you can see over there, I've limited it to three.
Got more irises under your weeping...
More iris, a lot of columbine, purple columbine. There's under the weeping cherry tree are not only the purple iris, but also the globe, the allium globe. There's a couple of those in there too.
And the rose bushes that we rescued.
Rose bushes that we rescued are fine. The one we bought died.
Yeah.
But oh, now this is interesting. This is just so bright. We were told this would be like a spotlight in the garden. It likes to grow, it's a coral bell. It likes to grow in the shade, which makes it all that more spectacular because it just stands out so brightly. And we planted it, it was maybe this big, and it's slowly getting bigger and bigger, and you can see that the coral bells are just about started.
Do you remember what color those coral bells are?
No, I don't. Now, this is something that I do not like. Maybe some people do, but to me, this is invasive. I'll be digging this out. Or maybe putting it someplace where we don't care. But that travels too much for me. Takes over. Okay. There we go. It doesn't look like the bell part is too spectacular, but the leaf part makes up for it.
Yeah. Well, all the, what do you call these behind you?
Oh, honeysuckle.
Honeysuckles,
vine?
Yep. The 10 honeysuckles you put in are really starting to grow.
Now you'll see this one's got aphids all over it. Now, where are my ladybugs when I need them? You can tell because it's got honeydew all over it.
Yeah, you can see. Look at right here.
Yeah, it's
leaf.
Awful. Horrible.
Can we spray that with a soap solution?
We can. Well, I'll make some soap and garlic solution up.
Okay. In fact, if you want to make up the solution, I'll spray it.
Sounds like a plan.
And how many people have asked about your hair? I mean...
Well, I look kind of crazy today.
Well, we were in Las Vegas, maybe 5 years ago? And we were going to go swimming or out to dinner, I think it was, and you asked me to cut your hair.
I did, because we'd been working in your sister's garden, or your mom's garden someplace, and it was just really hot and it was too long and I didn't like it, and so I asked you to cut it. You cut it with a kitchen shears, chopped on it. I fluffed it up, and then about a month later you found me a ceramic flat iron, and I started using the flat iron with your encouragement, and this is what's happened to it. And I get a lot of comments. Most of them are good, and one of my best friends told me I need to do a video showing how I do this, so maybe one day I will.
Okay, cute.
Now, Potentilla bush is quite often easy to find. You'll find the yellow ones and the white ones. Last year we were at a nursery, and lo and behold, they had a pink one. And we thought, oh my gosh, that is so cool. So we planted it, and of course it was the drought year, and we let it go a little too long at one point, and we thought we'd killed it. And so we just watered and watered and watered and said good things to it, and lo and behold, here it is. It made it, and it's blooming, and it's getting big. It's nice and full, so.
How about your dwarf lilacs?
These are dwarf lilacs, yep. We put these in when they were just teeny tiny. I think this is the first year they've actually bloomed. And they smell wonderful.
Yeah, we have some at the front of the house, too, right in front of the screen porch. So when we're sitting out there, you get these wafts of incredible...
Yes.
Delicious smell.
So that's one of the lovely things about spring. You just enjoy all the different smells. You go from one plant to the next.
Remember what we used to have outside the kitchen that had that great smell, and we've never been able to find it?
Yes, it was a fragrant Daphne.
Yes.
And we're told they only live 7 years at the most, but you can have it be wonderful 1 year, and the next year you'll come out in the spring and it'll be dead. But it was absolutely wonderful. It lasted almost all summer. I mean, you'd walk up the little stairway and there was always this beautiful fragrance. But we haven't been able to find one locally.
And we've been to many of the major nurseries too, and we asked them, you know, about it, and they kind of look at us like, what?
Mm-hmm.
So they have to end up looking it up in their books. And
then they'll say, no, we don't carry them.
Yeah. So if you know somebody, if you know somebody that carries Daphne's, let us know.
The fragrant ones, yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to import them.
I hope not.
Well. Yeah.
Now this is the front that we sit on the porch here, and the fragrances waft in at us. It's getting to the point where the blossoming parts are almost done now, and then we'll just have the plant structure for a while until the bleeding heart fizzles out. They'll kind of shrink down, and then you'll be able to see the bushes that we actually have in there. The yellow and green, I want to say it's Eumenius, I don't know exactly what it is, but then they'll show. And then more iris out there, and a robin eating our worms.
Yeah, I see daylilies out there.
Mm-hmm. And so the tulips are done now, the daffodils are done. The spring bulbs are pretty much done except for the alliums. And now we go on to the next phase.
Well, isn't it wonderful coming out for breakfast in the morning or even later in the afternoon and just sitting there and, smells are...
Looking for hummingbirds.
Well, that's another thing too. They really come in the morning and evening time.
Yes.
That's when we see them most of all.
Mm-hmm.
So, always fun. You know, people need three places. They need a place to work to feel productive.
Right.
They need a place to
come home to.
Come home to. And they also need a place to escape to. That's why people take vacations. And we decided, why not do all three at the same place? You know, then we can take a vacation as well.
Yes. We have that luxury of being able to do that. So
we escape to our garden.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's our tour for today. We enjoy it every day when we come out. Hope you've enjoyed it too. If you have, please give us a thumbs up, and thank you so much for watching.